Members of Parliament yesterday held prayers for the late Honorable Sarah Mateke Nyirabashisi at Parliament, thanking God for her accomplishments while she was still alive. A Thanksgiving service, which commenced at 2 p.m. yesterday, was attended to by various dignitaries and representatives from the government. While leading the prayers yesterday, the Anglican Church of Uganda's Archbishop Stephen Kazimba Mugalu regretted the passing on of Minister Mateke at a tender age.
Let me tell you, all of you here and now, people are looking forward to 2026. Many have already started. I am still around. Please remember me. But let me tell you, it's only God who knows whether you reach there or not.
Richard Todd Wong, the Secretary General for NRM, attributed the rampant sudden death of politicians to the stress that they encounter during their course of duty, and he advised them to occasionally take a rest.
The phone calls they receive in a day, the pressure they have, they have to run between constituencies, offices and the chambers. We pray that you find time within your busy schedule to relax and rest.
Prime Minister Robin Anabanja lauded the late Minister Mateke for her immense contribution to the welfare of the children and youth while she was Minister of State for Gender, Labour and Social Development.
Honorable Mateke was not only a remarkable leader, but also a passionate advocate for the welfare of children.
We shall not leave the son to move alone. We will move with you until, for the good and the legacy of your mother, we must keep the name Sarah alive.
The Minister of State for Defence and Veteran Affairs and Kisoro District Woman MP passed away on Saturday 7th September 2024 after suffering a heart attack. She was rushed to Mengo Hospital where she breathed her last. The late Mateke was the MP for Kisoro District. The leaders of NUP from across the country yesterday paid a visit to their party president Robert Kyagulanyi Ssentamu to deliver a sympathy message following a recent incident in which he was injured by a tear gas canister in Bulindo while he was coming from NUP lawyer's residence, George Musisi. They delivered to him various food items and other essentials as a gesture of expressing their sympathy. Kyagulanyi welcomed the gesture of kindness and informed them that he was steadily recovering. He further urged his supporters to remain undeterred.
Ntambuze migulu abulumi kubasobola kusimba kugulu bulungi. Naye okusinzira kubasawo sina bulabe bonna kati opapajo bwalimu basala ne babujamu ne babulongosamu.
Our power,
people power,
NUP,
everywhere, NUP.
A fuel tanker exploded after colliding with a truck carrying passengers and cattle in northern Nigeria, killing at least 59 people, according to Niger State Emergency Management Agency, OSEMA. Images showing burned out shells of vehicles, one still billowing with smoke and flames after the incident in Niger's Niger local government district, leaving a dozen of blackened and charred bodies of victims from Sunday's early morning incident.
The incident happened around 12:30 a.m. when a petrol tanker fell down and spilled all its contents on the road. Other incoming trucks carrying travelers from Kano and Anambra ran into it. And
the explosion happened after a petrol tanker loaded with PMS fuel collided with a trailer truck loaded with travelers and cattle, according to SEMA. Two other vehicles, a crane and a pickup truck, were also involved, it added, while more than 50 cattle were burnt alive. President Bola Ahmed Tinubu's office said that the president had directed relevant federal agencies in transportation and road infrastructure to redouble their efforts and work with state governments to enhance the safety and security of travelers and residents. Fuel tanker explosions are common in Africa's most populous city, where roads can be poorly maintained and residents often look to siphon off fuel following accidents. According to the Federal Road Safety Commission, FRSC, more than 5,000 people died in road accidents in Nigeria in 2023 compared to nearly 6,500 in the previous year.